Welcome back. Well, many of you know that our channel is the place where we explore history and technology of Chernobyl in such detail you won't find anywhere else, and today is no exception. Because today we have for you perhaps the most complex measurement device you can find across the reactor control room. And, you know, I have seen many things, but the way how this thing is engineered inside is something truly mind-blowing. But first, let me give you a little bit of context. As many of you know, we are building a functional replica of a part of the Chernobyl reactor control panel, specifically this one, the most iconic segment with the control rod selectors and the SZ5 and bus switches. It is going to be a very precise replica. Once it is all ready, there will be a big video here, but already now you can see the backstage of this project on our Patreon page. However, after a couple of talks with our consultants, who actually controlled that reactor back in the day, we realized one thing. Making just buttons and switches won't be really enough. And that's why we decided to also add this group of meters and indicators. We'll wire everything to a controller, and in this way it will be possible to simulate some operations. Among these devices there is this huge one, called the M1742. Here it serves as an indicator for the local automatic regulator. That's actually one of the most important systems for controlling reactor power. But as far as I remember, in the control room there are around 5 such meters with different scales located in different places. However, they were used not only at nuclear power plants, so we could find one for sale. We would just need to change this scale from milliamps to percent. Well, technically it is a milliammeter with 12 independent channels, but what's inside it is an absolutely ingenious piece of engineering. That's because instead of physical pointer, it uses a beam of light. On the back there are sockets holding powerful light bulbs, and inside there is an electromechanical system that distributes that light to the front screen. A basic example of this principle is the M1730 meter, which we showed in one of our videos in 2023. No, it's basic because it has only one single channel. So, this is what it looks like in action, though in reality it's much brighter than on camera. Inside there is a mask with a pointer's image, then a fixed mirror, a lens, and finally a rotary mirror which changes position depending on the current supplied. And the light then projects onto the scale. But for its 12 channels, the M1742 has only 3 light bulbs, so it has to be much more complex inside. But before I open it, I have to test it. And so I found a suitable connector and attached it to a simple adjustable current source, which I built from a few potentiometers and a 5-volt power supply. Okay, so the first 4 channels work perfectly, and there are color films attached inside the scale, so the beam also changes color. Well, the camera doesn't capture it well, so I'll make a slight shadow. It really looks cool. Okay, the next 4 channels also work quite fine, and finally let's look to the last 4. Okay, here is a slight problem, because 2 of the light pointers change their size as they move. I guess this means we will need to play with lenses inside. And that said, let's open it to check what we have inside. Ooh. Well, now I guess you understand why I explained the principle with a simpler device first. Well, this is actually really complex. Okay, eventually I figured it out. So look, here the light from the light bulb comes to a glass prism hidden inside this box. Then there are these 4 windows and each position so they send light in different directions. Then here there are 4 tiny mirrors, one per channel, and 2 of them send the light to these 2 larger mirrors. Then from there the light passes through these lenses, which focus it and reaches the ammeter heads, and each of them has own rotary mirror. And finally, the light from there reflects off these two long mirrors and eventually reaches the screen. For the other two channels, the path is almost the same, just everything is positioned slightly differently. And also there is one more extra mirror per channel, so the beams do not intersect. Well, looks absolutely insane, but that's really, really cool. In fact, I cannot say it's over-engineered, it's, you know, rather genuinely clever. I guess I will switch on the lights and maybe we'll be able to see how the beams travel. Well, I cannot say it's really very visible, but with some effort, I guess you can spot it. Alright, and now let's look at how the front display is built. Well, it's secured with about a dozen tiny screws, and then this is what we have. Inside those 12 white plastic inserts, and above them those colored films. Each part is fixed independently to a metal panel which has the scale. Well, we were told that at the power plant they used only red films and not green, but I'm not sure whether they used them in this particular device, so for now I'll keep them in place. And as we have the front display removed, let's use the chance to clean all this dust on these windows. Okay, and finally let's fix that problem with two faulty channels. And to do that, I need to remove these screws. Well, I have to say, I really love this modular design, because everything is accessible and serviceable. I've seen many Soviet-made meters, and this is a quite a great exception from the rule. So, as you can see, two pointers change their size when moving, and this technically means that we need to adjust the position of these two mirrors and these vents. Each of them has two screws, one to hold it in position and another for fine adjustments, so by rotating them simultaneously you can change the image. Well, I must say, that's really not a very easy task, and it's better to do it in a complete darkness. But eventually I achieved a pretty good result, and now the device is ready to work again. So, such an amazing piece of technology, and if you want to see more controls like this in our videos, just let us know in the comments. In the meantime, get ready to see another very cool project which is coming next week. That will be a radiation monitor that retrieves data about radiation levels in the Chernobyl zone and shows them on a vintage plasma display. And as always, you will find the backstage of our projects and tons of research data on our Patreon page, where are already more than 500,000 posts about everything Chernobyl. The link is in the description below. Thank you for watching, and we will see you in the next one.